Hello friends. So in the previous video segment, we have seen how we can design an 8:1 multiplexer. And here in this video, we shall see how we can design an 8:1 multiplexer using 2 4:1 mux and 1 2:1 mux. Now, what is an 8:1 multiplexer? So this is the block diagram of an 8:1 multiplexer where we have 8 inputs I0 to I7. And since you have 8 inputs and 1 output, how many select lines do I need? Now, n happens to be the number of inputs, which is 8, which is 2^3. And to find the number of select lines m, to get the number of select lines m, we use the expression log n to base 2. So that's going to be log 2^3 to base 2. So we get 3. So we need 3 select lines. So here, we also can include an enable, and that of course is optional. So let's, for the time being, eliminate the enable. So with these 3 select lines, so we can write the truth table. So what does the truth table suggest? When the select lines are 0, 0, 0, the output y is tied to input I0. So whatever appears here at I0 will also appear at the output. So when S2, S1 is not a 0, 0, 1, I1 appears at the output and so on. So now, is it possible for us to design an 8:1 mux using 2 4:1 mux and 2 1/2 mux? It is possible. Now, if you look at this table here, we observe that this portion, S0 and S1, is the same, isn't it? I have 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. But for the first 4 combinations, S2 is 0. And for the next 4 combinations, S2 is 1. So you will get an idea as to how we can design this 8:1 mux using 4:1 and 2:1. So can I implement this using a 4:1 mux? Yes, it is possible. Now how do I do that? I use a 4:1 mux. So therefore you have I0, I1, I2 and I3. So this is a 4:1 mux. So when I have a 4:1 mux, I need to select line, so it is S1 and S0. Right. So when this is 0, 0, I have I0 coming here, 0, 1, I have I1, 1, 0, I have I2, and 1, 1, I have I3 coming here. Now similarly, I use another 4:1 mux with the same select lines S1 and S0, because these two are identical, isn't it? But the inputs are different. It is I4, I5, I6 and I7 and the output here. So again, when these two are 0, I have I4 coming here, 0, 1, I5, 1, 0, I6 and 1, 1, I7. Now what happens? I need to select the first 4 when S2 is 0 and I need to select the next 4 when S2 is 1. So there is only one select line. So if I have one select line, I can use a 2:1 mux, or I have to use a 2:1 mux, where the outputs of these two 4:1 mux now become the inputs to this 2:1 mux, and the select line would be S2. So here, since there is only one select line, when S2 is 0, I'm selecting the first 4:1 mux. So I select this 4:1 mux, so whatever appears here will also appear here at the output. So when S2 is 0, and when these two are 0, 0, I0 appears here, will appear here. When this is 0 and 0, 1, I1 will appear here and also will appear here, and so on. Now let's consider S2 being equal to 1. When S2 is 1, this is selected. The second input to the 2:1 mux is selected at the output. So when S2 is 1 and these two are 0, 0, I4 is selected here, and this data comes here at the output. Now similarly, if S2 is 1 and both of them are 1, 1, I7 comes here and this I7 will also appear here at the output Y. So this is how we can actually design an 8:1 mux by using 2 4:1 mux and a single 2:1 mux. Now in order to do such designs, what we need to observe is we first need to write the table here and identify the select inputs. Now we find that S0 and S1 they repeat for the first four combinations and the next four combinations, except that S2 is changing. Now S2 remains same, which is 0 for the first four and 1 for the second four. Right? So therefore, S2 becomes the select line for the 2:1 mux, whereas S1 and S0 become the select lines for both these two muxes, both these two 4:1 mux. So this is how we can design an 8:1 mux by using 2:4:1 and 1:2:1 mux, and it's very simple and very interesting too. So I hope you have found the video informative and interesting. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe, and press the bell icon to get notifications of further uploads, and thanks for watching.